So hello, what is up YouTube? Welcome back to another episode of Nama Moto Vlogs. This is Tofiq here, back with another video.
It's never too late to make a difference.
Today is Monday, 11th of May, and I'm just heading towards Joe's garage since I wanted to change my front brake pads because the last time I actually put high performance brake pads on my motorcycle, but since there was no stock of EBC or any good brake pads, the last time I left my bike for service I had to get Nissin brake pads for the front calipers, which I pretty much didn't like, and the problem that I started facing with those brake pads was overheating, squeaking sound, too much of brake dust, and the fading bite of the pads, I mean of the brakes. So I used to use EBC earlier before, and a year back, Farhan told me that there are something better than EBCs, and I was like, EBC is such a known brand, and what is it, the other thing? And he was like, it's called CL brake pads, CL racing brake pads, and those two are sintered brake pads, double H rated. But I was pretty much skeptical about going for those brake pads because I never heard of those brake pads. But then someone told me, who go to MMRT, for those of you all who don't know what MMRT is, MMRT is a racetrack in Chennai. So someone also told me, I started getting out reviews about those brake pads who have already used it, and someone told me it's like pretty much very good brake pads, and go for it, you won't be disappointed if you put this on. And I did, and I actually felt a lot of difference if you compare it to EBC brake pad, which was like a very good thing for me. And supposedly if EBC lasts you around 9000 to 9500, 10,000 kilometers on the front brake pads, the CL racing amazingly lasted for a longer period of time than EBCs. And EBC costs you around 2500 Indian rupees, and CL racing is a slightly costlier brake pad. So that was one of the other reason why I was skeptical, because I had never heard of that company, and it was even costlier than EBCs. So once I had put them on, I was already a fan of those brake pads. It doesn't eat your rotor that much. For people who say don't put thicker pads and harder compound pads on your front disc calipers, it will start eating your brake rotors, I didn't face any issue. And I usually change my rotors in every 15,000 kilometer, because even though I don't see the rotors getting affected so much because of the hard compound brake pads, I want to be always on the safer side. I want to do a better maintenance of my bike so it lasts me longer. This bike is 2015 model, as you all know, for the people who have been following me on Instagram. And for those of you all who are not following me on Instagram, I would suggest you guys to do. My Instagram link is given in the description, and I have reached Joe's. So this is how Joe's garage is. They pretty much have all the superbikes lying down throughout the year, and I see some green coolant on the floor, I don't know for what. So see you guys. So we are here at Joe's, and these are the brake pads that I was talking about. As you can see, the old brake pads are getting replaced. Oh, dikhao purane brake pads. So this is the comparison between the old and the new disc brakes. This pad, as you can see, it's almost done. And look at the new ones. This is how they look front and back.
So once the brake pads are removed, you spray some WD-40 to clean the calipers and take out all the dust and muck that is there on the calipers. So once the cleaning is done, you will push back the pistons so there is enough space for the new brake pads to go in. Once the resetting of the piston is done, what we do is fix the new brake pads in, and this is how it's done. You have to set it in, put the clip and the piston bolt. So as you can see, we have opened up the brake reservoir over here, because once you push back the calipers, the pressure inside the braided lines and the caliper is completely disturbed. So you have to again press the brake lever and rebuild the pressure in the calipers and the lines so that the brake works completely fine. So we are done with the brake pad change, and we had to bleed the brake lines a bit since the air pressure was completely gone, and the bite of the brakes are not good because once you replace your pads to a new brake pad, the new brake pads aren't rough, the surface aren't rough, so when it rubs the caliper rotors, it doesn't have so much of bite because the surface of the new brake pad is pretty much smooth. What I like to do is I like to accelerate the bike and hold the brake slightly, a little bit, so that the new pads get rough and I get enough, like, see, there is no bite at all. And it's advised that you shouldn't ride fast for a couple of kilometers till the time you get confidence your brakes are amazingly working fine, because I'm holding the brakes pretty much hard and I see that there is no that much of bite, and I always do that. This is my way of making the pads rough, and now I can feel a little bit of bite on my brakes.